In this video, I'm going to show you how to load and remove filament from your 3D printer. I'm going to show you the best method for feeding in your filament, as well as how to remove your filament when you're done with it. The printer I'm using for this demo is the Ender 3 version 2, but many of the tips will be transferable to whatever printer you have. The first thing you need to do is prepare your filament reel by removing the end from any holes or notches that hold the end of the filament. These are designed to stop the filament tangling when you're not using it. Make sure you hold on to the end, because letting go means the reel unraveling and tangling, and you don't want that, trust me. Any kind of tangles in your filament is going to stop your print. Place your filament onto your spool holder and then pull on it gently to make sure that the filament is going to feed out smoothly. If you have any kind of tangle, sort it now before feeding the filament into your printer. Make sure that there are no kinks in the end of your filament, especially where it was held on the reel. If there are any kinks that you can't easily straighten out, make a clean cut on the end. When you cut the filament, make sure you cut at an angle so you're left with a point. This will help it guide its own way through the extruder gears and Bowden tube or into your hot end or whatever setup you have. Sometimes even with cutting the filament this way, it can still snag on things on the way through. If you still have problems, then make a second cut so that you're left with a point on the end, and then you shouldn't have any problems at all. With one hand, depress the extruder lever and feed your filament into the filament feed hole in the lever. The filament should line up pretty well with the extruder gears, but if the end of the filament is curved slightly or it doesn't line up for any other reason, give the filament a little bit of a twist. Only ever twist about half a turn and then back the same amount. Don't go winding a load of turns into your filament, that won't help you. You should find, with a twist, even the most wonky of filaments should feed in. Use this method to get the filament to go through any of the next guide holes. At this point, setups vary, but the twist method will still help get the filament through to the hot end. Release the extruder lever so it holds the filament still. Now warm up your hot end, not just to the melting temperature of this filament, but to just above the melting temperature of the previous filament you used. Why is this important? Well, imagine you were last printing with something with a higher transition point, like PETG. Unless you've thoroughly cleaned the nozzle and hot end, there's going to be a little bit of that plastic left behind in the nozzle. If you don't then heat the hot end, and therefore the nozzle, up to the transition point of this material, then it's never going to melt and pass through the nozzle when the new material pushes in behind it. So if you're now feeding in PLA, which has a transition point between 180 and 200 degrees, it's never going to actually melt that PETG that was in there before and get it out of the nozzle. So just make sure when you're feeding in the new filament, you go to the higher temperature of whatever you were last using. While you're waiting for your hot end to heat up, go into your printer settings and move up the Z height so you have a good clearance between your nozzle and your bed. I suggest about 70mm. Once you're up to temperature, depress the lever again and then feed the filament in until you feel it come up to a little bit of resistance. At this point, check your nozzle to see if any filament's coming out. If nothing's coming out, then with the lever still depressed, feed the filament a little bit further. If the filament has reached the nozzle, you'll feel it gently push in and you'll see a little bit of filament extruded from the nozzle. If you've come up against a hard stop and there's no filament coming out when the nozzle's up to temperature, then it means that the filament snagged somewhere else in the system. Go back to the trusty twist method and you should find it will clear and pass through, even if you have to retract it a little bit and go again. Once you do have filament extruding from the nozzle, keep pushing the filament until you can see that all the old filament is out. If this is the first time you've put filament in, then once you see it come out the nozzle, you can stop. However, if you're pushing out old filament, make sure you keep pushing until you're sure that the old filament is completely out of the nozzle. Now, if you're changing colours, this is obviously easy because you can see the colour change. But if you're using two different materials of the same colour, make sure you go a little bit too far and extrude a little bit too much filament rather than going the other way and not feeding out all of the old filament. Your filament is now loaded and your nozzle is purged of all the old filament. Now set your printing temperatures and get printing. If you're enjoying this video, remember to like and subscribe. I'm currently making regular content for 3D printer users of all experiences, and I'm sure there'll be something you'll enjoy coming up. Subscribing ensures you won't miss out. So what about removing your filament at the end of a print? Well, firstly, you don't have to remove the filament at the end of each print. It's perfectly fine to leave filament loaded into your 3D printer between prints. It won't cause any damage. Just bear in mind that if you don't have your filament in any kind of dry box, then it will be exposed to moisture in the air and dust. Both of these can cause print issues, so if you're concerned at all, just follow this method to remove your filament. Removing the filament is very simple. Make sure your hot end temperature is at or above the temperature you were just printing with, and depress the extruder lever. Now, don't just pull the filament straight out. What I've found is if you do this, it will leave a lot more old filament in the hot end and actually in places where it won't re-melt again, and this can actually cause a blockage. Instead, before pulling the filament out, gently push it in a little bit so that some filament is extruded out of the nozzle. Once you feel it pushing through the nozzle, then quickly pull back about 2 inches. This should shear the filament off cleaner in the hot end and shouldn't leave anywhere near as much half-melted plastic in the system ready to cause problems later. Now you can pull your filament all the way out and carefully roll it back onto the reel, making sure that the end is trapped and it can't unwind. Remember to cool your hot end down and turn your printer off. You've now successfully loaded and unloaded filament from your 3D printer. Click here for more videos relating to the Ender 3 version 2, or click here for another video you might enjoy. Thanks for watching.